Welcome back to Bio School. Today's topic is capture mark release recapture method. At the end, I will solve some previous year CSIR question related to this topic, and there will be a question for you. So let's get started. Capture mark release recapture method. It is used to estimate the population size of a given species in a given environment. Okay, this method is used to estimate the population size of a given species in a given environment. How population size is estimated by using this method and what are the steps of this method, that is in its name. So what are the steps? Let's have a look. First is the capture. Okay, the capture means we have to capture the group of individuals from a given environment. The second step is mark. After capturing the group of individuals, we have to mark those individuals so that we can identify. How we can mark? We can mark the individuals. If the individuals are the large mammals, then we can mark by using the ear tags. In case of the small mammals and the birds, rings and the bands are used for marking. Insects can be marked by using different paints. Okay, after marking the individual, the third step is release those individuals to the environment from where they were captured. Okay, then what is the next step? After releasing those individuals, in the second sampling or the resampling of the individual, we have to calculate the total number of individuals those are captured for the second time, and out of which how many individuals are recaptured. Means how can we know that those individuals are recaptured? Because those individuals are captured in the first time and are marked. By using the data of all and by applying a simple mathematical formula, we can estimate the population size. So here in the diagram, it represents the population of mice. It's the total population of mice. So what is the first step of this method? Is to capture. The N1, it represents the first capture. Okay, so some of the mice are captured, then they are marked or tagged with yellow color. After marking the individuals, they are released to the total population from where they were collected, so that they can mixed with the other individuals, those who are not marked. Then the next step is resampling of the individual or the second time capturing of the individual, which is represented by N2. In the second capture individuals, we have to calculate the number of individuals which are recaptured. By using this data, we can estimate the total population size. Okay, and how the population size is estimated? That is estimated by using the mathematical formula, that is called the Lincoln index. What's the formula is? The formula is N equal to number of individuals marked in first catch multiplied by total number of individuals cast for second time divided by number of marked individuals recaptured in the second time. So N equal to MC by R. Here N represents the total population size and M is the number of individuals marked in the first catch. C is the total number of individuals captured second time. And R is the number of individuals recaptured in second catch. Okay, so let's have an example. Let's say we catch 50 largemouth bass in a lake and mark them with colored fin tags. A week later, we return to the lake and catch 40 fish, and 5 of them are previously tagged fish. Okay, so in the first, how many pieces are collected or captured? That is the 50. So M is the 50. 50 pieces are collected and they are marked with the colored fin tags. Then they are released. A week later, we return to the lake and catch 40 fish. So second time, how many pieces are captured? They are captured just 40 pieces are captured in the second time. Out of those 40 pieces, 5 of them are previously tagged fish. 5 of them are previously tagged fish means 5 pieces are recaptured. So R equal to 5. by applying the Lincoln's index, n equal to mc by r. So n equal to mc by r, by putting the all the value, we got the population size. So n equal to 400. So what are the assumptions of Lincoln's index? The assumptions are, all individuals have equal chance to be selected. There is no reproduction, no migration, no mortality and natality. And last, marking does not affect the behavior of individuals. So these are the assumptions. What is the drawback of capture, mark, release, recapture method? Maybe some of the individuals, they avoid trapping. They can't be trapped or cast for the second time. So imagine that instead of the 5 tag piece, if we only get the 2 tag piece, then what will be the estimated population size? So here, instead of the 5, the r will be the 2. So n equal to 2000 divided by 2 is the 1000. So the population size is greatly different. This is the major drawback of this method. Okay, what are the other names of capture, mark, release, recapture method? This method is also called as Lincoln index, Lincoln-Peterson method, capture, mark, recapture method, capture, recapture, mark, recapture, and also site, recite. But all these methods, if they use same formula, that is n equal to mc by r, to estimate the population size. So here is the previous year question. A grasshopper population is being assessed by capture, mark, release, recapture method. On the first day, 100 grasshoppers were captured from a given area in 1 hour time. So how many grasshoppers are captured for the first time and marked? That is 100. So m equal to 100. On the next day, using recapture, 10 marked and 90 unmarked grasshoppers could be found in the same time period from the same area. So it says that in the second capture, they captured 10 marked and 90 unmarked grasshoppers. Like means the total is 100. Out of the 100, 10 are marked. So the number of individuals captured for the second time is also 100. That is, the m is 100 and c is also 100. And the how many individuals are recaptured? That is the 10. So now we got the value of m, c and r. M is the 100 and c is also 100, because 90 are unmarked and 10 are marked. So 90 plus 10 is the 100. And how many individuals are recaptured or the marked individual is 10. So by applying the formula n equal to mc by r, we got the value of n is 1000. So the correct option is option c. Okay, what is the second question? In an experiment to determine the number of rats in a field, 80 rats were initially captured. So how many rats are initially captured or first captured, marked and released? That is 80. So the value of m is 80. After 1 month, 100 rats were captured in the same field. Okay, then the second capture, how many number of individuals were captured in the second time? That is 100. So value of c is 100, of which 20 were previously marked once, out of which 20 were marked, means there's a recapture. So value of r is 20. So based on the above observation, estimated population size of rat in the field will be, so here m equal to 80 and c is the 100 and r is 20. By applying the formula n equal to mc by r, we got the value of n is 400. Okay, so the correct option is option c. Here is the question number 3, and I hope you all will be able to solve or estimate the population size by using capture, mark, release, recapture method. So try to solve this question and comment down below. Thank you for watching my video till the end. Please do like, share, subscribe, and bye bye. See you in my next video.